just doesn't ever seem to get nervous because he's really mellow in that way. I usually get more nervous, and Richard gets more nervous than Nathaniel does because he just does his usual.
We got the big one tomorrow. We're going to Momentum Mill Creek to do some stretching and just like kind of stay active, stay fit. I have a little ritual before every competition. I like to stretch it out, keep the blood moving. Key to success, honestly, the Magos formula is handstands. Y'all didn't know, heard it here first. Rehabbing the finger, trying to make it feel good for tomorrow. It's feeling pretty good right now. I mean, it's been steadily improving for a couple weeks now. I just injured a pulley a couple weeks back, climbing in Moe's, trying this thing called dirt bag. There was a roof, good three-finger mini jug, and I just yarded on it too hard, and the pulley snapped.
I think I hurt my finger. My first response is, do you need a doctor? And then he's like, no, I think it's okay. You know, I'm gonna call Tyler. Then I got mad. And I'm like, you've got comps coming up. You can't hurt yourself like that.
Regardless of whether we were at the peak of our game, me and the Salt Lake crew were gonna go out and show our hometown what we can do in comparison to the nation. Even though I'm worried about getting injured, I wanna compete with my friends and represent Salt Lake.
I had really high hopes that, you know, he's gonna defend his title, he's in great shape, he's just gonna kick butt. Now I'm a little bit more realistic and thinking, okay, he's gonna climb. But he seems to have a really good attitude about it. So if he makes it past qualifiers into semis, I'll be happy. You know, I mean, if he has fun, I'll be happy. You know, I just want him to have fun and enjoy it.
Open Bouldering National Championships. Welcome everybody to the Salt Palace. Nathaniel Coleman also not having the best round, is he? We sort of wondered if this would be the case today, given his injury.
Daniel's definitely going to need this one and make it on to finals round this evening.
Daniel losing the heel there, and that's sent him to the mats.
Over a minute to go, Nathaniel Coleman, number four.
90-ish seconds to go for Nathaniel Coleman on men's four. To even have a chance at finals, he will have to top this out. Throw away all expectations, all previous notions. This is the 2017 Bouldering Nationals. We've had a lot of upsets for the men. No Nathaniel Coleman, no Daniel Woods. No Sean McCall.
We hung out for probably like an hour at the venue just to wait and see if we could get a finals list. And that whole time we were quiet. I had already prepared myself mentally to know that I hadn't made finals.
Yeah, Kristen, when we went off the air after our semifinal round, we thought that defending national champion Nathaniel Coleman did not make it to finals, but we found out Nathaniel just made it in ninth place.
First out of the gate, your reigning national champion, Nathaniel Coleman!
Nathaniel Coleman swinging into action! That is what the Nationals is, people! High flying action! Nathaniel Coleman climbing with authority!
Oh, that's Nathaniel with a quick flash of men's one.
Beautiful!
Did you expect that to happen so quickly?
Nathaniel is capable of flashing just about any boulder we could throw at him.
Nathaniel Coleman just swooping up problem three. Three flashes and three problems for Nathaniel Coleman. That is going to be hard for anybody to catch up to him on. Final problem now. Find out who's going to be the national champion for 2017. Is it going to be Nathaniel Coleman? Could be his championship moment right here. He flashes this problem, it is all over for the men. Impressive Nationals performances I've ever seen, Chris and Neely. Just the entire round that he had, sort of not quite sure what was going on, and then all of a sudden just dropping the hammer in finals like that.
Yeah.
That is right.
It's got to be really special for him winning in front of his hometown crowd here.
Thanks, dog.
Salt Lake City crew is psyched right now.
And that is that, folks. Nathaniel Coleman is our 2017 bouldering national champion, two in a row.
In perfect style, four flashes. That was beautiful.
Comps have always had a place in my life because of that high energy. I don't need it all the time, and I don't want it all the time. There is something to be said for a low-key day out with the boys. Places like this let me rest a little bit and like rejuvenate the psyche. Kind of struggling with my psyche for climbing. I've been like watching all these new films that have been coming out about developing, and I'm like, wow, like what an incredible process. That just magnifies the mystery of climbing that I already love when I go to a boulder and like don't know any beta. So yeah, I was like super psyched on it.
Do you see like that big like multi-fridge compression rat up there?
Oh yeah,
dude,
far left.
Yeah. That looks sick.
We've driven past this roadside zone like a few times and just never bothered to check it out. There are a lot of big boulders up on this hill, and then I guess one day we were just having a really unsuccessful time walking up canyons, finding nothing, so we decided to go back to like square one. Anytime I'm standing under a boulder that towers over me, I feel the need to stand on top of it, which is exactly what Air Dog was. And especially because it's overhanging, when you stand at the base, it's just like this massive monolith that you want to get on top of. Right side is not as good as the left side. This is like the only real hold. And then you have like a few slopers up to this divot. Here, once I'm here and here,
definitely housing it.
I think you're gonna hit that rock.
Maybe.
What happens if you hit that rock?
I bounce. I don't know what it is about me, whether it's like the people who've influenced me. Like Kyle O'Meara always tells me it's about the power of the psyche, and if I can just like enjoy it and be in the zone, nothing can go wrong. This bowl like leaks out the bottom. There's like cracks in it.
Oh, you can see it start to bead.
Being in this positive mental state all the time is definitely better than getting down on yourself and getting angry at yourself. And I see all these climbers that like take it way too seriously, and then it just like compounds and they get more angry at themselves. And I think that's like important to how I've developed as a climber and like my mental attitude all around when I'm climbing outside, when I'm projecting, and when I'm like in a competition. If something doesn't go my way, I don't let it affect me because I know that I'm a strong climber and that I'm good at what I do. It's like all this micro beta, and like 1 foot you start and then you get like a foot an inch higher and then a foot an inch higher. Throw the foot around the arete. This is all like the foot beta. I'm so eternally grateful that we found this place and that like we're developing it as a crew and stuff. It's like, it's just like exactly what I needed at this time in my life, honestly. Because I just didn't know what to do. I wasn't in school, I'm not working. Just starting to be like a pro climber. So, yeah, this is like the perfect dedication of my psych. That was like a perfect moment. Everything just like followed my beta exactly. Everything hit perfectly. You don't get many of those in your lifetime, man.